Annunciators and indicators help us determine the status of different systems, but they also let us know when there is a problem or when something requires our attention. This is another useful video for home cockpit builders and flight simulator enthusiasts, so please make sure to like, subscribe, and share. For flight simulators, these are available in different shapes and sizes, but the most important detail is the electrical specification. In my sample panel, these LEDs are 5 volts, and can be connected directly to an interface card such as an Arduino. And these are 12 volts, which will need a relay or other electronic device to separate the 12 volts required for the LED and 5 volts required for the input to the interface card. Unlike push buttons and switches, LEDs require interfacing, and in this example I will be connecting these directly to an Arduino Mega 2560. Let's start with the 5-volt LEDs and their wiring diagram. Please note I am using LEDs with built-in resistors and my Arduino has an external power supply. The ground can go to a common ground or directly to the Arduino, and each LED can go to a digital output. In our example, we are using pins 22, 30, 36, and 42. That's it for the wiring. On the programming side of things, I will be using MobiFlight to interface between the simulator and the Arduino. After installing MobiFlight, I go to Settings, load up my modules, and add the LEDs and their respective pins. I upload and save the configuration, then go back to Output Configs and add the LEDs here as can be seen in the following configuration. Since I am working on an old prototype, I will be using FSUIPC to read offsets and program the Arduino card. The configuration would be no different for Flight Simulator 2020 or reading data refs on X-Plane. Finally, I can test the configuration by clicking Test and watching the LEDs turn on and then off. When it comes to the LEDs themselves, make sure to explore what's out there. Multicolor LEDs allow you to display several colors. As an example, for when the landing gear is down, I can use blue for general aviation aircraft, green for commercial, or red when there is a failure. Also, make sure to explore the LED bezels or holders, which come in a variety of materials, such as metal or plastic. For 12-volt LEDs and annunciators, it is a bit more complicated, but still simple enough for anybody without experience to set this up properly. In this example, each annunciator or LED requires its own relay like the one we see here. I previously reviewed relays and LED push buttons and switches, so please make sure to check out that video for more details on how the relay works. Let's review the wiring diagram for this sample panel. We need an external 12-volt power source. This will be wired to the relay as follows. The LED or annunciator terminals are then wired as seen here, and get enabled when the Arduino closes the 5-volt circuit after communicating with the simulator through MobiFlight. When this happens, the 12-volt circuit is closed and power is provided to the LED. When the simulator turns it off, the Arduino opens up the relay, which also disconnects the power to the LED. Please write any questions in the comments section and make sure to like, subscribe, and share. Thanks for watching.